Hi there, this is LT Survival. Well, this morning I'm gonna make a couple of short videos for the Christmas period because I ain't gonna be much around in that time, so I want you to have a weekly video still every week. So the following video is parts of a compass, so stay tuned. We'll go on to the overhead stand so that way you can see the compass and see all the parts to it. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Okay, we've seen basic compass like this one that my grandfather used. They have basic part. We're gonna just see them for a while. At the end, I'm gonna put up a couple of image that you can stop on and see more of the parts. You see here, there's the needle. Okay, there is the compass rose with the degree and the casing. This one is really simple. Okay, it has a latch also to block the needle from moving when you have it in your pocket. This one is really the simplest of them all. But they all have the same part. I'm going to use another simple one, okay, to show you the basic part. So we have the base plate here. We've got the dial, okay, around here. You see the needle reacting to my and the needle again. This is a compass rose. This one is so simple. It has no notch to tell you on which bearing you're going in. So again, this one and the older one that I have here are basically the same. This one being more of a quick reference compass, something basic. This is dollar store type compass, so nothing to expect. It has rulers on each side and the scale, so you can make the coordinate on the maps and the lanyard, so you don't lose it. Okay. In the more complete compass, the one I like the most is this one. Oh, yeah, you see the camera installation. Okay, here we go. Okay, we're gonna start with the top. We've got the sight, we've got the mirror casing, we've got the mirror itself. Okay, the mirror casing is basically there to protect the mirror and the bezel so that way it doesn't move in your pocket when you close it down and put it in your pocket. And that's funny because I see myself in the mirror in the camera. So I'm gonna close in on the dial here. Okay, and again we do have the base plate. Okay, we do have the base plate, which is here. Okay, and we'll come back to those parts. We're gonna go inside the dial. On the dial, you have your scale or orientation degrees or mils. This one is in mils. Okay, we can see it if we go to north here, which has 64. You had two zeros to that number, and you've got 6,400 mils, which is the military way of doing it. You can have degree compass. I have one here. I'm going to switch them up. And you can see if we go to north here, you've got zero and 340 here. So 350, 360, you've got the zero, which is north. Okay. Same compass. This one has a particularity. It has a bubble. See the bubble? It blocks my needle. So this one is too big of a bubble. So it should be replaced. I keep it just for educational purposes. So let's come back to my original one. Okay. Inside the compass, there is many, many tools. Okay, inside that circle or that scale. How do you say the dial? Inside the dials, there's many features. There's a needle here, not a needle, a screw here that goes with the screwdriver on your lanyard, still in a lanyard. Okay, in this Okay, this screwdriver will be able to move the declination marker here from 0 to 90 on either side. Be careful, it's not, you've got the west side on this and the east side on this for the declination. We are west. This one's about 16 or 17 degree declination. Okay, we'll come back to declination when we talk about it. This one has a particularity. You see the small arrow beside the orientation. Well, you see where the needle is? It's the orientation arrow. This one is moving because of the declination. You've got parallel line on either side. The needle is stuck to my pointer. And you've got that small arrow. When you go vertical, this scale, okay, you put it to north, and you sight basically the inclination you find on a mountain, and you can determine the number of degrees you're going up or down. So basically it's a clinometer needle, okay? That's a third one. I've talked about the black lines. The black lines are parallel. They're called parallel, or they're called meridian, okay? Let me just check. Yeah, the meridian. So the these are where you want to be. That's you're going to be using with the map. Okay, you got square lines on the maps, and these goes with it. The orientation marker, the direction to which you're walking. This is a larger one, and there's a small dot. You've got the back bearing, so this is the bearing you're walking to, the orientation. And in the back, you've got another marker for the back bearing, and this is the latch for the cover. Okay, let's zoom out again, stand by. Okay, globally, you've got the peep sight here, the orientation line in the center of the mirror, which is in line with the bearing markers, and the back bearing here in the back. The hinge, of course, and the mirror can also be used in survival for signaling mirror. So you always have a mirror on you when you have a compass, a compass with a mirror. There is two scale on this, there's four scale on this. There's two rulers on each side, okay? One in millimeter, the other one in inch. Okay, I've not used much of these. If I put the mirror flat, this is a continuous line. So it's like a ruler. You can use it on your maps to draw a line or to find out an orientation, a bearing on the maps using the mirror and the base plate as a line in between. There is also square scale here and here, which are marked one over 50,000 and one over 25,000. This is for making the coordinate on maps with the same scale of these two. Unfortunately, the 1 to 20,000 that the government of Quebec use is not common enough to find them on a compass, but there is scale that there is tools you can buy if you're using those, or you can make your own. We'll see that in a future video. Of course, on the dial, since we're back, we've got the north, the south, basically the four cardinal, and we've got the intermediate. So that's good enough also for basic orientation. This is a compass. This is a compass that has the declination scale in it, and this is about the best you can use because it permits you to walk with precision in the woods. There is different format. You all seen this one. This one is a smaller one, but it has no adjustment for the declination and the orientation arrow is fixed, so you have to compensate mathematically from map to compass, but it has the same features. It has no scale on the bottom. Some of them do. This is the same exact one, but in degree, it's from Sunto instead of Silva. The Silva are getting difficult, hard to get, but the Sunto are pretty common and not expensive. 150,000 and 125,000. They have no rulers, which basically are useless. You can measure with the rulers distances in straight line, referring to the scale that you have on your map. Let's bring out the map. I have a basic map for you, which is basically this, and I'm going to touch that very carefully. This is the north and south, and because you've got the graphic here saying where the north is, this is the meridian or the north-south lines, the parallel, okay, also called parallel, X and Y in mats, so X and Y. So basically there's numbers and there's scale of the map. That scale, when you use those rulers, you can measure, okay, on that, the distance between the point. This one is not to scale, it's just a training map that we use for basic handling, because we have no fuss, not too much details. So we're going to see the maps also, and the all the standard feature that we have on the map, like this is to know where the map is in relation to others. So if you're exceeding one map, you know which one you're going to have to do to get the next map around. This is the declination scale. You always have a title which has Canada on it. Same title will be here, okay, and scales and some more information around. And you have your lines, okay, which we gonna be explaining later on. So this is how you put the compass if you want to go from there to there, and you just move your parallel to the parallel, huh? The parallel to the parallel. So the meridian parallel to the line, both of them meeting up, so in a parallel way, and you've got your bearing at the top. So that's just an application of this compass, the way it is. So basically, this is it. This is all the part you need to know. What else did I miss? Did I miss something? Sometime you'll find magnifier, okay? Might be useful, like this one, okay? Might be useful if your eyes are not that great, like mine's, but I don't use magnifier because my glass is always in my face, so it shouldn't be essential. In the size of the magnifier, this one is pretty good, but on those that have magnifier here, they're pretty small, so it might be more important to have your scales with you if you're reading maps with coordinate. That can be translated into a GPS because they're UTMs, so I'll be teaching that also in a further video. Okay, I'm gonna put up the two graphic of the parts of the compass. I'm gonna say it in one straight phrase in English, so that way you can see them, can pause and read them. But there is always available also on the internet. Okay, so. As you see, a compass is a fairly simple thing once you've mastered the name of the parts. The parts are the reason we master, first of all, the parts of the compass is so we have a common language. You talk to a doctor and he talks medical, you ain't gonna understand nothing. If you have knowledge of the term he's using, you will be able to understand what he says. So this is the reason why we take a compass and we go around saying this is the parts, so that way we talk common language. With our cadets, when we teach bearings. When we teach how to take a bearing, we make sure that we understand what we mean. The orientation arrow and the needle, the red on the red, are the bearing. So basically, if I say put the needle, the red needle with the red arrow, they all know what part is going to go together. So they ain't going to put the clinometer into the arrow. They will put the magnetic needle with the arrow so they can read a bearing with the bearing markers. So that way we can teach them, because it's difficult to have your face at the same place as your student while he's doing a bearing. It's difficult to be in his place and not doing it in his place. So you have to talk the same language. That's why we spend so much time. We spend usually a good 30 minutes on parts. It takes about 15 minutes to go around the parts, and we haven't made a game to see if you understood. That's why I put the image in between the conclusion and the main and the overhead view on the show, on the campus. As you can read on the motto of my chain, it is learn today for real. I have a blank. Learn the basics, survive tomorrow. I just did the French one, so that's why my brain was not saying what it was. So learn the basics, okay? You learn the basics so you can use them tomorrow. That's basically everything that you learn in life. You learn to drive before you drive, because once you're driving, things gonna happen, and you gotta know what to do in that case. So basically, it's everything about school that should be. You learn the basics, then you apply the basics, and then you master the basics. And that's the way it should be. So hope you like this video, and we're gonna try to see the maps, the details of a map, with the overhead support that I have here. We're gonna learn how to use a map. We're gonna start by seeing what's on the map and what details can be used. So if you like this video, give it the thumbs up, share, and subscribe, and we'll be right back with another video another week.